Hello viewers, thank you for joining us again on the segment of devotion on GOFtv. You are welcome once again on the general topic Theatra, the Adulterous Church, and the youth topic we have Test Every Gift with God's Word. Why adult topic, Danger of Compromising Faith. To the intermediate, don't tolerate unbiblical teaching. For today, 16th July 2015, Thursday, our focus for this devotion, a peculiar people. A peculiar people. Our text is taken from 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9 to 12. 1 Peter chapter 2, if you are there with your Bible, or with your iPad, with your phone, you can open with me as we read together. Before we read together, let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we ask that by your Holy Spirit, you will illuminate your word. Let the entrance of your word give life and give understanding to my viewers, in Jesus' name. Amen. I read 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9 to 12. But ye are a chosen generation, holy nation, a peculiar people, that should show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light, which in time past were not a people, but are now the people of God, which had not obtained mercy, but now have obtained mercy. Dearly beloved, I beseech you as a stranger and pilgrim, abstain from fleshly lust, which war against the soul, having your conversation honest among the Gentiles, that whereas they speak against you as evildoers, they might, by your good works, which they shall behold, glorify God in the day of visitation. This is the scripture for you today. And I want to tell you that as a peculiar people, God expects you that your qualification as a peculiar person is not just a mere one. For you accepting Jesus Christ as your Lord and your personal Savior, haven't taken that decision in your life, it becomes very necessary for you that your life become a different life. The way you conduct yourself, what you do, how you relate with people, your disposition to things are different. Although we are in the world, but we are not of this world, says the scriptures. But the issue here is that we are not just to quarantine ourselves somewhere and begin to tell ourselves that we are this, we are that. What our conduct should be is contact without contamination. As you move with them, let your life be distinct. In Matthew chapter 5 verse 16, the Bible says, let your life so shine that men might behold your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. I want to tell you this, dear viewers, that it is necessary that our conduct must reveal the changed life. And that is why the scripture is telling us today that we must take cognizance of that conduct. As a changed person, as a born-again believer, we must take conduct. We must take conscious of that conduct. And as we stay conscious of that conduct, the Bible says here that our conversation must be honest before men, as they look at us, as they relate with us, so that even at the end, they might be able to glorify God through our life. What is your life saying? Are men glorifying God through your life? What are they saying about you as a Christian? Or what are you even thinking about yourself as a Christian? What are the other relatives, your neighbors, your co-workers, people that know you or must have had some dealings with you? What are they saying about you? I want to tell you this day again, that if you check your life and you discover that there's different thing that men are saying about you, then you need to visit the Calvary again. Why not go there for second touch? And as you do that, so that you can be a peculiar person, so that you can manifest what it is you ought to. Look at that scripture again. It says so that in verse 11, says, dearly beloved, Paul was writing and is crying. He said, I beseech you. That is, I beg you, I behold on you, that you live as strangers and sojourners, as pilgrims. And what does that imply? What does that imply? You discard yourself from this worldly lust, worldly attaches. Love not the world, neither the things of the world. For they that love the world, they pass away with the world. And that's the same scripture. Peculiar person that have a focus of heaven. Peculiar people that know where they are going to. They are not thinking of here. In every of their dealing, in business, they think of God. They think of that place. In anything they do with you, they think of that place. They are not thinking of you. And that is the message to you this morning. A peculiar people. Live a life of a peculiar person. And as you do that, the Almighty God will bless you. I want to tell you this morning again, that as you do that, your work will show whose servant you are. Beloved viewers, I believe God has spoken to you this morning. I'm of the opinion that as you go out this morning, the Lord will bless you. Let's bow down our heads to pray. Father, we thank you for this word. Thank you for your word that you have spoken to us. Bless our going out. Bless our coming in. Make us to shine as light, so that men might look at us and give glory to your name. Help us to live that purified life. So shall it be, in Jesus' name. Thank you, viewers, for listening. Thank you for the opportunity to join me in this sector. I want to tell you again that by the special grace of God, you can join me tomorrow, same hour, same time, on this same channel, and the Lord will bless you. For any comment, question, you can please join the link, and I'm sure that by the grace of God, the Lord will bless you. Thank you. Have a wonderful day.